To start a polling session from the desktop software, simply open the iClicker Cloud software, then sign in using your iClicker Cloud instructor credentials. Next, hover over the name of your course and click Start Class. This will bring up the iClicker Cloud toolbar. You can collapse the toolbar by clicking on the cloud icon and expand it again. Next, open your presentation software. Now you're ready to run polls, the most popular activity our instructors engage in. They're fun, they're challenging, and they reach our students' brains in brand new ways. Let me show you all the different ways you can ask polling questions of your students. With older versions of the iClicker Cloud software, you would have a menu bar and a toolbar to manage. Now we've simplified the software so you only have one item to manage on your desktop. You can quickly switch between activities without ending your session. When the toolbar is expanded, you can click on the checkmark icon to start a polling session. You can click on the pen and paper icon to start a quizzing session. And you can click on the people icon to view your in-class attendee. Clicking on the red X will end your class session. To start your polling session, click the check mark. When the polling option is selected from the class toolbar, polling options are displayed in the same toolbar. You can return to the main class toolbar by clicking the back arrow. The green circle with the white triangle starts a polling question. This icon is like the shutter icon on a camera app. When it is pushed, it will capture whatever is on the screen and send it to student devices. So make sure you're displaying the view you want your students to have. The drop-down menu lets you change the question type. The bar graph icon lets you view and grade results. And these ellipses give you more polling options. Here, you can turn on anonymous polling, or you can change the timer to count down instead of up during polls. To ask a multiple choice question, be sure to have selected the proper question type, then have a question ready to ask your students. When everything is ready, click the green circle with the triangle to turn the poll on. You can minimize the toolbar while a poll is running, and this pulsing icon appears to indicate that a poll is running. If you minimize the toolbar further, the cloud icon will pulse to remind you that a poll is running. Here's what it looks like for students. They get a screenshot of your question, and they choose the response they feel is correct. When you feel enough time has passed on the poll, simply push the red button to stop the poll. Now you can click on Results to view and grade the results. Simply touch an answer to turn it green and mark it as correct. You can have multiple correct answers, and touching a correct answer again will return it to ungraded. Remember, you can always view results and grades after class at the instructor website. Clicking on the results icon will close the results panel. Let's ask another question. Here's an example of a short answer question. Simply go to the drop-down menu, change it to short answer, and then click the play button. Here's what it looks like for students. Students can respond with up to 140 characters like a tweet. You can see when you've received a response on the toolbar. When you're satisfied with the number of responses you've gotten, simply click Stop. And again, clicking on the Results button will let you see how your students responded. You can click on an answer to mark it as correct, or you can manually enter a correct response. Short answer responses can also be viewed as a word cloud. Obviously, this is more interesting when you have a lot of responses. Clicking again on the results will hide them. Let's try another question type. This is an example of a numeric question. Simply select the question type from the drop-down menu, and then click the play button. Here's what it looks like for students. Students can answer with up to 8 digits, and they are limited to using numeric responses. When you're happy with the number of responses you've gotten, you can click the stop button. Again, you can click on the results button to view how your students have responded. In the results window, you can also click on this compare button if you want to compare different results to different questions. Clicking the results button will hide the results. And now you're ready to ask another question. Remember, questions can always be graded after class as well at the instructor website. Here's an example of a target question. With a target question, students are sent an image of a question and they touch where they feel the correct response is. Simply select target from the drop-down menu and then click the play button. Here's how it looks for your students. They simply touch where they feel the correct answer is, and then they click send. The student can move their response as many times as they like until you stop the poll. To grade a target response, click on the results button, mouse over the question and click on it, and then simply draw a box around where you feel the correct answer is. You can also make this response window much larger. Click Save when you're happy, and it will automatically grade the question. Lastly, you can ask anonymous questions with iClicker Cloud. To ask an anonymous question, first make sure that you have the right question type selected from the drop-down menu, then click these ellipse buttons. Select Anonymous. You'll see that the polling toolbar turns black to remind you that you're asking anonymous questions. Turn the poll on by clicking the play button. Here's what it looks like for your students. Students select the answer they want to send, and then you'll notice that their answer disappears. This makes it so that their anonymous response cannot be viewed by any of their classmates sitting around them. When you're happy with the number of responses you've gotten, click the stop button. Clicking on the results button brings up the results of the poll, but please note, anonymous responses cannot be graded. So be sure to only use anonymous polling when you do not need to communicate a correct answer to your students. To turn off anonymous polling, simply click the ellipses again and click on anonymous again.